Happy Valentine's Day. It is here. It is all about love. Man, I love you guys. I love the fact that you tuned in. I love the fact that I can see you right now. Wait. I love the fact that you can see me right now. Sorry, I guess I can't see you guys. But hey, got the theme, don't you? It's all about love. And this is what I want you to do. I want you to make sure that you tell your parents, your grandparents, your dog, your cat, and your goldfish, and your hamster, and for you guys that have snakes out there and spiders, tell them how much you actually love them. But I have a better story about somebody who loved you more than I do, because man, I do love you guys. But there was one that came. For God so loved the world, he sent his only begotten son, Jesus. You know the name. We've been talking about the name. You see, Jesus loved us so much that he died for us on this cross. See, God sent him to walk this earth. He did all these miracles that we've been talking about. And it was just to show not only that he's God, but how much he cares and loves you. He healed the sick. He made the lame walk. Made the blind see. Then he went down that road and died on the cross for you and me. What that really means is how much he loved you. And it also helps you get to heaven, because that's the only way. The Bible tells us only through Jesus Christ that we must be saved. And we'll sing about that song here in just a few minutes. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. But what does that mean to you? What does that really mean? And how does that translate into, ooh, big word. Well, I mean, what does it mean for you? Well, listen, it's easy as the ABCs. See, I told you it was important to learn how to read and write, because I'm talking about reading and writing right now. Well, ABCs, Jesus is, hey, first you got to admit, you got to know that you're a sinner. We've talked about that. Romans 3:23, tongue twister, says that we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. Well, you know, sometimes it's tough, but we do things wrong. And that's what it means to sin. When you don't do something that God just tells you not to do and you do it anyway, that's sinning. And then we got to believe. We got to believe in Jesus. We got to believe that he came, walked on this earth as God and as man, and then he went and died on the cross for us. And then C, confess our sins to him. It's that simple. A, B, C. That's all you have to do. But it's very important that you do that from the heart, where that love comes from. Remember, love. Jesus is love, and he loves you. So let's sing about Jesus saves. Love you guys.
Cross
Wow, wasn't that two awesome songs right there? Man, I love Jesus Saves, Jesus Saves. And I hope you understand the concept behind that and what that really means, because it's really important. And now, the story, which is an amazing love story in itself, as Jesus helps one of his friends. Let's check it out.
Jesus and Lazarus were friends. Lazarus lived in the town of Bethany in Judea with his sisters Mary and Martha. One day, Lazarus got sick. Mary and Martha sent a message to Jesus. "Lord, your friend Lazarus is sick," they said. Jesus told his disciples, "Lazarus' sickness will not end in death. This sickness will bring glory to God and to the Son of God." Jesus stayed where he was for two more days. Then Jesus said, "Let's go back to Judea." By the time Jesus arrived in Bethany, Lazarus had been in a tomb for 4 days. Martha hurried to meet Jesus, but Mary stayed home. Martha said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother wouldn't have died." Martha knew Jesus could do a miracle, though. "I know God will give you whatever you ask," she said. Jesus replied, "Your brother will rise again." Martha believed that Lazarus would rise from the dead in the future on the last day. But Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me, even if he dies, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will never die, ever. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," Martha said. "I believe you are the Messiah, the Son of God." Martha went back to her house. She told Mary that Jesus wanted to see her. So Mary left the house, and all the people who had come to comfort Mary and Martha followed her. Mary fell at Jesus' feet and said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Mary was crying. Jesus wept too. Mary led Jesus to the tomb where Lazarus was buried. It was a cave, and a huge stone covered the opening. "Remove the stone," Jesus said. So the stone was moved aside. Jesus looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you heard me." Then Jesus shouted, "Lazarus, come out!" Lazarus came out of the tomb, wrapped in linen and cloth. Jesus said, "Unwrap him and let him go." When Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead, he showed that he has power over death. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." Jesus died on the cross for our sins and rose from the dead. He gives eternal life to those who trust in him.
Wow, wasn't that something? Hey, only God, only Jesus, resurrect his friend from the dead. Now, let's go see what Pastor Brian has and some of these other kids that have questions out there, and let's see what he was able to answer. Check this out.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Robert from Franklin, New Hampshire asks,
"I know Jesus has power over death, but I still feel really sad when I hear someone has died. Is it okay to be sad?"
It is definitely okay to be sad. Let me just be clear about this. If anybody has experienced death in their family or extended family or friends or anybody else, it's okay to feel sad. I would actually go farther than that and say that God wants us to feel sad because people are a good gift from him. He wants us to enjoy these relationships. He wants us to care deeply about people. And if we don't feel sad when somebody dies, then that means we didn't really value that friendship, that relationship. So feeling sad is not just okay, I think it's good. We want to mourn when somebody we love is gone. But here's the beautiful thing. They're not gone forever if they're in Christ. We know that all of us who have trusted in Christ will be reunited again for all eternity, and so it's only a temporary separation. This is why we mourn, but we mourn with hope. We're sad, but we're sad with joy at the same time, even though it sounds like those don't go together, but they do because of Christ. You know, in today's Bible story, we see that Jesus wept at Lazarus' death. And that alone reminds us that it's okay, it's good, it's right and fitting for us to mourn over the death of somebody. And Jesus did that knowing he was going to raise Lazarus right away and talk with him again just in a couple of minutes after that. So find encouragement that it's okay to be sad. We should be sad when somebody we care about dies. So here's a couple of questions back for you. How do you feel knowing that Jesus cried over death too? And how is it helpful to know that death was never part of God's design?